leave something to remember, so they won't forget I was here. I lived, I loved, I was here. I did, I've done everything that
day has come to let you go. Only happiness I will show. I'll always be here for you. You know, nothing takes away my love, and it shows. You've grown up now. Things have changed. Grew some wings now. You're flying away. I'll always be here for you. You know, nothing takes away my love, and it shows. Yeah, nothing takes away my love when I let you go. You're my baby, always will be. I hope you know my love stays when you go. Some years down the long, long road. If you need help with your load, I'll always be here for you. You know, nothing takes away my love, and it shows. Yeah, nothing takes away my love when I let you go. Ooh, 'cause you're my baby, always will be. I hope you know my love stays when you go. 'Cause you're my baby, always will be. I hope you know my love stays when you go. I'll let you go. I'll let you go. 'Cause you're my baby, always will be. I hope you know my love stays when you go.
When I wake up to your footsteps, as you get up out of bed, we make a song that sounds so simple, but it dances in my head. A melody so perfect that it gets me through the day. And the thought of us forever is one that won't ever go. All I need to know is where to start. Take my hand and show me forever side. Never will I ever let you go. So let's hold on together to this paper and this pen, and write down every letter to every word we've ever said. All I need to know is where to start. Take my hand and show me forever side. Never will I ever let you go. Let's write a story and let's sing a song. Let's hang our pictures on the wall. All these precious moments that we carved in stone are after all. And all you gave me hope, but I've gotta let go. I've gotta let go.
Good afternoon. Thank you. Please remain seated as the seniors enter the field house. Please stand for the national anthem. Good afternoon and welcome to West DePere High School. It's great to see each of you, and it's a wonderful day to celebrate the class of 2022's graduation. Ms. Rollin, choir students, Mr. Glaney, and the band students, thank you for participating in our ceremony and sharing with us your talents. Welcome back to those of you here that we haven't seen in years, and welcome back to West DePere. If this is your alumni or graduates, and if you're a first-time visitor, welcome to West DePere. This is my 18th year standing at this podium, and I used to give a long graduation speech, but several years ago we revamped some of the graduation program, and for that maybe you're thankful. Now I give brief opening remarks. What hasn't changed is my thankfulness, admiration, and appreciation for all of our K-12 staff. We are who we are, our success, and the success of our students is because of our K-12 staff. Please stand. We live in a time of technology that I am not completely used to, or quite frankly, comfortable with. After I see or hear what people are posting, I can't imagine that I'm alone in this, but I also realize that I'm old. There, I said it for you. So for those of you that can't resist, I'm going to give you a couple things to post. This is the perfect setting. High school principal, 2,500 guests. Let's get this out there. Post this. Four of our seniors are going to the military. Thank you. Eight seniors finished their school career with straight A's. Seventy seniors had a GPA of 4.0 or higher. 189 seniors took at least one advanced placement course. 1,570 total college credits earned by this class, 1,570. I did the math for you. At UW-Madison, $600 a credit, that's $942,000 earned by this class in college credits. One senior, Caden, had a perfect score of 36 on the ACT. Congratulations. $2.3 million was awarded in scholarship money to the senior class. And maybe most importantly, 242 students in this class. That's not the good part. 242 are graduating. It's 100%. Please post all that. We're so ready for this special day. Let's get started.
Good afternoon. My name is Zach Suda, president of the graduating class of 2022. I am honored to have the opportunity to welcome all of the graduates, families, friends, teachers, and other fellow students here today. We are given the opportunity today to recognize the accomplishments and successes of the class of 2022. I'd like to thank all of you for joining us on this highly anticipated special day, as well as to thank Dr. Gerke, Superintendent Krieger, School Board President Ms. Foose, the rest of the school board, all of the parents who guided us through the years, and everyone else who assisted in this journey of success for all of us graduates here today. There are two things I want to leave you all with today. But the second one doesn't come without the first. And the first message that I want to relay to all of you is not only useful guidance to just the graduates, but to everyone in this room in their own walks of life. Last year, at about this time, I lined up for the mile at the Appleton North Regional Track Meet, and I took sixth place. My season was over because only the top four advanced. I remember going home that night telling myself, I'm going to work harder than ever all year to make it to sectionals next year. But now that championship season is upon us once again, my 4x800 meter relay team is in a position to run our hearts out with a chance at qualifying for state. The moral of my story is to never put a limitation on your potential. Never let your goals restrict your outcome. Why just try to make it to sectionals when you can make it to state? Why set a goal for your soccer team or your basketball team just to make it to state when you could win state? Why settle for a B when you could put in all that extra hard work to earn that A? Or why just go run a marathon when you could qualify for Boston? In any walk of life you choose, this message makes a difference on how you strive for success. It is impossible to feel completely satisfied from hitting a goal that you know you could reach, but when you put in the extra time and the extra effort to reach what you thought was impossible, that's when the true feeling of success is achieved. Now, the next thing I'm going to say is going to sound highly controversial, but just let me explain myself before you all look at me like I'm crazy. Don't listen to your parents. Now, I don't mean when your parents tell you, be home at midnight, and you think to yourself, yeah, right, see you at 2. Trust me, you'll want to be home by midnight. I know. Or when they tell you, put away the dishes, just put the dishes away. What I mean is that all of our parents want what's best for us, but no one is perfect. Parents will give you all of the advice in the world, and most of it is valid. But what they can't tell you is what you can be. Follow your heart and follow your dreams. You'll never find complete fulfillment in life unless you become the unique individual that you've always wanted to become and accomplish the amazing things that you've always wanted to achieve. Set goals along the way that seem impossible in the short term, but amazingly impressive in the end. Never let any obstacle or anyone define your future. The opportunities to try new things are endless. So let's not be afraid to go with our instinct and try something we've always wanted to do. Now is the time. Let the journey begin.
Four years, 36 months, 720 days, 5,040 hours. That is a lot of time we have spent here together in this building. That is, if you include the 3 months we spent doing algebra and reading Of Mice and Men in our beds during quarantine. You can choose to count your time in high school as years or months, or you can choose to count them in life lessons. We have all learned a lot about ourselves and life as a whole in these past 4 years. Here are the top 10 life lessons I have learned during my time here at West Chapier High School. Number 10, no one is going to do it for you. No one is going to make you get out of bed. No one is going to make you do your homework or make you go to the job interview and get the job. Nobody is gonna put the hard work in for you. Only you can choose to do that for yourself. Number 9, how you talk to yourself matters. If you tell yourself you are going to succeed, you are already halfway there. If you tell yourself you're going to fail, you are already 10 steps behind. You will spend a lot of time in your own thoughts, so make them kind. Number 8, you are who your friends are. Whether you would like to admit it or not, the people you surround yourself with become a direct reflection of your own character and your own values. Spend more time with people who build you up and motivate you to be better. Number 7, say more thank yous. Looking at life through a lens of gratitude brings brightness to every dark situation. Thank you should become an overused part of your vocabulary. We all have so much more to be thankful for. Number 6, put yourself in situations that make you uncomfortable. Nobody ever got where they were meant to be by remaining comfortable. We need to let go of familiarity in order to grow into the person we were meant to be. Number 5, coffee is your friend. Whether you need a Monday morning pick-me-up or simply just need the caffeine to keep you going, treat yourself to coffee. And if coffee isn't your thing, find your thing that makes you excited to get out of the bed in the morning. Number 4, the days are long, but the years are short. Spend more time with your siblings. Hug your parents often. Be diligent and challenge yourself, but do not forget to let yourself have fun and make memories. We won't be this young forever. Number 3, forgive. You will only ever feel stuck if you cannot let go of the hardships that hold on to you. The peace you feel with yourself will be much greater than the bitterness you feel towards the person that hurt you. Wish them well and move forward. Number 2, It is really only you versus you. Instead of asking yourself, where am I compared to everybody else? Ask yourself, where am I today compared to where I was yesterday? The real competition is always found within yourself. And if you are better than you were yesterday, you win. Number one, look forward to who you will become, but appreciate yourself and be proud of the person you are right now. Tell people you're proud of them, but don't forget to look yourself in the mirror and say, I'm proud of you too. You may not be where you want to be yet, but that's okay. Remember that what you used to look forward to is what you are living in right now. Maintain goals for the future, but always cherish and embrace the stage of life you are currently living in. I am sure we all have memories in high school that we'd rather forget. But my challenge for you is this. Reflect on your top 10 life lessons that you've learned over the past 4 years and carry them with you as you begin your new season of life. Class of 2022, we have been through a lot, and I am honored to have been able to walk alongside you on this journey. I hope you always remember how capable you are and always stay as proud of yourselves as you are right now.
More than anything. Lately, I've been thinking a lot about time. The past few weeks especially, I've been looking back on my time spent in high school, and I've been thinking about the times to come in the future. I haven't been enjoying my moments in the present as much. The last few weeks, my focus has been on graduation, finals, scholarships, and sports, and less on what's most precious, the now. Time is the past and the future, not the present. Often, we tend to focus too much on time and less on the present, the most precious thing. As I've been thinking about time, I've been thinking about an hourglass. Two glass globes connected by a narrow apex that regulates the flow of sand to measure intervals of time. Essentially, time passes through the hourglass. Our lives, especially our high school careers, can be represented by an hourglass. Think about it. I'll start with the bottom globe, filling with sand. The bottom represents the past, bygone moments. Now, the past is great. The past is for remembering and recalling precious moments, like syrup chugging at football games, or winning the noise parade every year. And we definitely can never forget about the wonderful creation that is Chili Crispitos. We also tend to dwell on the past. Like the sand filling the globe, our minds get full, thinking about the assignment we didn't do great on or the game we lost. Although we dwell, pretty soon our memories pile up, and those memories get buried in our minds. It's hard to keep those memories clear, just like it's hard to see clearly through the hourglass as the sand accumulates. On the opposite end, we have the top globe, which represents the future. The unknown. It's empty. We don't know what it will be filled with. It's exciting, but it's also very easy to get caught up in worrying and questioning what is to come. Will I do well on this test? Where am I going to college? How do I do taxes? What the heck do I want to do with my life? We worry about these things that aren't even there yet. Although we try to, we can't predict what each grain of sand will represent in the future. So, we have the past and we have the future, but they have to connect somehow. And that's where the final component of our hourglass comes in. Though it's the smallest piece, it is also the most essential. The apex, where the two globes meet. By sitting in the middle of the past and the future, it represents the present. The now, this moment. It certainly doesn't hold as much sand, and the sand passes through pretty quickly. With two big pieces surrounding it, it's not what we are drawn to. It's not easy to focus on. However, it is by far the most important component of the hourglass. It reminds us of where we are now, in this moment, rather than dwelling on the past and anticipating the future. Presence takes practice, but we can start right now. And as right now is our last time together as a class, let's take right now to be present. Focus on your classmates sitting next to you, our teachers and staff who have helped us get this far, and our families here to support us. And in just a little bit, as you walk across the stage to receive your ticket out of here, be present in that moment. Don't think about the past. Don't worry about the future. Appreciate it one last time before we leave to journey into the real world. Our past has passed. The future, we can't predict. After today, no matter what route you take, keep focusing on the middle of the hourglass. Enjoy every moment of the now, because it truly is the most precious thing there is. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Before I begin, I would like to say thank you to all of my peers who selected me to speak in front of you today. Never in a million years did I think I would be speaking in front of nearly 2,000 students, parents, faculty, and community members. It is truly an honor, and I am overjoyed to be given the opportunity to do so. For those who do not know me, throughout the past 4 years, I have been an active member of the West Appear High School cross-country team. Although I am slightly embarrassed to say that my personal best time may or may not have been set during my first race of freshman year, I never gave up, pushing myself to work harder and get better. Likewise, I cherished every single moment I got to spend with my team, including the times we ran in pouring rain, hail, and even snow. While some might say that the key to being a successful cross-country runner is speed, as somebody who is a horrible sprinter, yet still received all conference honors, I will tell you that something else is much more important. This thing is not a special pair of shoes, genetic trait, or superfood. Instead, it is a mindset that many endurance athletes commonly referred to as running your own race, or taking advantage of your own unique talents and trusting your instincts despite what the people around you do or say. In my case, this was pacing. However, the concept of running your own race isn't just limited to cross country. Rather, it can be applied to several components of our lives, especially right now. Today, when we walk out these fieldhouse doors for the last time, we will be starting the next mile of our lives. After the final song is performed, we will all be going our separate ways. In other words, beginning our own races. Some of us will be continuing an apprenticeship or joining the military, while others will be attending 2-year and 4-year universities in the fall. Regardless of the path you choose, remember that it is your race to run, not your friends or your parents. For the first time in your life, you will be able to decide what you eat for dinner, what time you go to bed, if you're anything like me, 9 p.m. sharp, and what chores you do or do not do. All of these choices you make, good or bad, are completely in your hands. Despite this increase in freedom, just like cross country, you are still susceptible to encountering obstacles that are entirely out of your control. Fallen trees, puddles, and gigantic hills will be replaced by final exams, job interviews, and unexpected bills. However, as I like to say, for every uphill, there is an equal and opposite downhill. Eventually, given enough time, things will get better. On the other hand, should you find yourself experiencing a flat section of pavement, a point in your life where everything is falling into place, never forget that others around you might be struggling and in desperate need of a helping hand. All in all, after this ceremony ends, you must be ready to trust your gut, control what you can control, and assist anyone who is stumbling. Most importantly, though, you must run your own race. And lastly, before I leave you this afternoon, I would like to end by sharing a quote from a very, very famous long-distance runner by the name of Forrest Gump, who says that no matter what life throws at you, run, class of 2022, run.
Thank you, Alexander. Class of 2022. Commencement brings closure to one chapter in each of your stories and marks the beginning of something new. You have achieved the success celebrated today by learning while exploring your own interests and experiencing life through your own unique lens. As you move on, look back with pride And always know that there are people here who care about you and your future and are here for you. This day marks a time of a new beginning, and you will now embark on the next chapter in your journey. Members of the Board of Education, each individual has met all the necessary criteria as prescribed by policy and law. They stand ready to receive their high school diploma. It is with confidence that I am able to present the class of 2022 to the School District of West De Pere's Board of Education. So on behalf of the School District of West De Pere's faculty and administration, I proudly present this class of 2022 for acceptance and confirmation. I now welcome School Board President Ms. Jenny Foose.
Thank you. Good afternoon. It's an honor to be here with all of you today. West De Pere is a district of pride and excellence. We're proud to offer opportunities to learn in diverse settings to ensure all students are college and career ready when they graduate. The class of 2022 has not only achieved academic success, but you've also given tremendous support to our community. You have dedicated more than 9,100 hours to volunteerism, including to Exceptional Equestrians, the West De Pere Summer School Program, churches, cleaning ATV trails, and so much more. There's an incredible feeling of empowerment, pride, and achievement in individuals who give their time in service to others. Volunteering offers a platform to those who wish to have a passion to drive change within their community. And it's an opportunity to make something better than it is today. It has been said that people don't decide their future, they decide their habits, and their habits decide their future. Class of 2022, continue to make it a habit to work hard and serve others. You have the ability to make a difference in the lives of those around you by building a stronger community for generations to come. You've all worked very hard to get this special milestone in your lives, and your time here at West De Pere has prepared you for a successful future. It is my pleasure, on behalf of the School Board of West De Pere, to accept the class of 2022. Congratulations on your graduation, and best of luck to you. You've made West De Pere proud.
Samuel Roman Elkanovichus. Mia Lynn Catherine Anagost. Xander Lee Ansel. Trevor Michael Augustine. Mitchell Glenn Augustine. Ava Marie Ayala. Cameron Dean Bacek. Lucas Andrew Bartelt. Nicole Jean Baumgartner. Lorelei Ann Becker. Emily Barbara Berner. Christian Joseph Bilgo. Aiden James Blasick. Mitchell Donald Bloom. Kevin Robert Blahowiak. Aubriana Alfonsina Bollard. Sophie Lee Bollard. Evan John Bow. Jocelyn Marie Brayton. Rachel Lauren Bry. Bradley John Burkhard. Amber Rose Burns. Jillian Bernice Bushert. Chloe Marie Calloway. Daniel Russell Campbell. Kyle Wing Carter. Kirsten Ann Cavill. Kirsten Pazhong Chang. Samuel Kevin Cherney. Marvin Milo Schrang. Jackson Ambert Wilkins Clancy. Claire Mackenzie Clavel. Grace Gladys Collar. Christopher Charles Coolidge. Jenny Grace Crandall. Riker Owen Crooks. Xavier Thomas Day. Morgan Mabel DeGroot. Isaiah Kennedy Delabrew. Isaac William Dennis. Wyatt Harrison DeSmit. Quinn Edward Diedrich. Trenton Michael Dolan. Carter Anthony Dugree. Amber Marie Dunham. Grace Catherine Ellingson. Caden James Engelbert. Madeline Zoe Farah. Seth Ryan Fink. Ellen Olivia Finley. Connor Wolf Flood. Allison Rose Fox. Spencer Robert Francis. Josie Lynn Fredrickson. Brianna Lee Foose. Dominic Jose Enrique Garcia. Jocelyn Rose Garcia Zimmer. Danielle Emily Gauthier. Nicholas Six Gerardin Hoffman. Sean Jackson Giroux. Grayson David Gifford. Miles Leo Gobin. Abigail Josephine Gullicky. Jairis Galen Goodman. Jaden Allen Gorski. Ryan Thomas Gorzlanchek. Carly Elizabeth Green. Fiona Jane Green. Jacob Paul Grossklaus. Miles Jonathan Grun. Jason Allen Hawk. Haley Grace Hassel. Abby Elizabeth Habetler. Kaden Anderson Hanula. Grace Elizabeth Harches. Ashton Michael Haupt. Jacob Michael Hayes. Grace Elizabeth Heyer. Nathan Christopher Hecla. Damian Michael Hine. Kendra Noelle Hennigus. Quinton Hayden Herdman. Cameron Lee Hermson. Jack Thomas Hersher. Aniquit Kane Hill. Kai Richard Hillman. Bryn Elizabeth Holzer. Maddox Lorenzo Horkman. Isabella May Ruby Wabino. Bryant Matthew Yeager. Gavin Bradley Jashinsky. Luke John Jokey. Emily Mae Jensen. Kennedy Ray Johnson. Emma Rose Kaiser. Brett Christopher Kane. Jonathan Mark Castor. Taylor Diana Kasich Seek. Amarissa Janelle Kibbe. Lydia Nicole Kolbeck. Sean Anson Colts. Mackenzie Lee Connup. Alexander Milton Kralovec. Lillian Mary Kreischer. Serena Jean Crumry. Alexis Starr Kuhn. Everett Lee Kutzler. Dayton J. Lambert. Paige Elizabeth Langrader. Danica Rose Larson. Allison Marietta Larson. Emma Leah Larson. Ava Grace Lax. Andon William Lemon. Scout Rebecca Lex. Alex Michael Lynch. Michael Isaiah Lynch. Evan Michael Motter. Zachary Robert Magnan. Jasmira Fuyi Maloney. Caden Jeremy Moss. Sydney Marie Moss. Abram Austin McGrath. Caitlin Jean Mertens. Sana Elizabeth Mertens. Jade Maria Millar. Beyonce Renee Miller. Zachary Thomas Momarts. Natalie Lynn Morshinsky. Addie Lynn Miller. Haley Elizabeth Nita. Ethan Paul Newens. Gage Hunter Newman. Diani Isela Nieto. Anna Jude Nimmer. Amani Faith Ninham. Tyus Eric Olson. Christian Julius Mark Omdahl. Alyssa Marie Ostranga. Om Atul Patel. Jada Rain Patterson. Paige Olivia Pilon. Lila Louise Peterson. Emma Marie Pichette. Emily Carlene Plannert. Jacob Robert Polson. Adriana Alicia Pinozo. Oriana Capri Pinozo. Natalie Lawrence Pop. Riker Gabriel Paquette. Allison Marie Price. Colin James Price. Dylan Gerald Price. Lorraine Q. Angel Gabriel Quinones. McKenna Lee Rabida. Jessica Grace Redant. John William Rader. Gabriella Hildy Ryan. Alexandra Marlene Rice. Maxwell Jacob Rice. Max Julian Renard. Marissa Paige Ressler. Owen River Richmond. Jade Manning Ricker. Cody Richard Rewe. Emily K. Rinke. David James Robertson. Tyler Allen Rodewald. Samantha Ann Rose. Eli Kevin Roscom. Bree Elizabeth Rosmirek. Kaylee Claire Rucamp. Isaiah Matthew Saxey. Alyssa Marie Song. Marissa Elizabeth Song. Brianna Lynn Schaefer. Samuel David Scheibel. Carter Jackson Schmidt. Colin Troy Schneider. Kirk Allen Schultz. Gabrielle Marie Schumacher. Lauren Lynn Schumacher. Sophia Paige Schovald. Miles Douglas Schultz. Noe Miguel Sierra. Marissa Michelle Sines. Cassidy Alvita Smith. Samuel Jackson Smith. Ariel Louise Smits. Gracelyn Marie Smits. Morgan Ann Smits. Brooklyn Ray Steyer. Brandon Allen Stevens. Bryson William Strabler. Zachary Turner Suda. Ethan David Sousa. Preston Gerard Tennyson. Amanda Jean Teske. Samuel Attaway Thompson. Zachariah Gerald Charles Tobison. Ethan Matthew Tomaszewski. Dalton James Trudell. Caden Joseph Turbit Reimer. Alec Ontario Ukula. William Richard Vandehy. Melody Patricia Vandenhoevel. Renee Susan Van Dyke. Caden John Van Price. Tygen David Van Schindel. Brock Anthony Vaughn. Ryan Charles Verhasselt. Kelsey Ann Vickman. Luke Robert Vickman. Cerise Mary Voiles. Seth David Ward. Austin Anthony Watlett. Josie Elizabeth Weber. Jeremy Thomas Weller Jr. Brett William Welsing. Clayton James Werner. Connor Frederick Werner. Nathan James Wesolowski. Eva Marie Westine. Joshua Bruce Wigman. Tressa Marie Wilkie. Cody Bad Bear Wade Williams. Marina Georgine Wood. James Thomas Winmiatek. Tyler J. Zaronas. Cooper Thomas Zerjev. Madeline Ray Zerbel. And me, Ella Josephine Wall.
Can you believe it? We are a single speech away from walking out those doors for the last time. A matter of minutes, and I will make sure those minutes are as short as possible, is all that stands between us and wherever we plan to go next. Our next chapter in that wonderful book of life stretches before us, full of endless possibilities and everything that high school isn't. I'm sure you're waiting for me to go on and on about all the fun I had in high school, and how much I'll treasure the memories, and how I'll miss it so much. But I've come to the realization that I'm ready to leave. Was high school fun? Yeah, of course. But I'm ready for more. We are ready for more. We're ready for a challenge, a reason to grow in areas that we haven't seen yet. We're ready to figure things out for ourselves, to choose who we spend our time with, to leave some things behind. Personally, I'm ready to escape the oddities of my house. We are simply ready for the next chapter. So, what does the next chapter look like? We got the all-important piece of paper that says we learned something in the time between homework, extracurriculars, sports, and maybe sleep. Great. What do we do with it? We can't just cash it in for the next page or even the next paragraph. We have to find the page ourselves in whatever way works for us. No one's holding our hand anymore. Some of us are continuing our education, whether that's attending a university or a technical college. Some of us are jumping right into work. Some of us are going into the military. Some of us have no idea where we're going, and that's okay too. The point is, we all have somewhere to go. So I'm not going to stand up here and make you sad to be leaving high school. The truth is, I'm really excited for us. This is our chance to make our mark, to be more than a flow of high schoolers in a crowded hallway. I'm excited to leave all the drama and cliques and frustrations of high school behind us. So I hope that when we walk out those doors in our neat lines, we are happy and not sad. High school was a chapter in your book of life. It's time to turn the page and start the next one. Have a good life.
When I say that I'm going to have a 90-minute program, I hold right to it. We have one more minute. So you just sit still. Now, I'd like to ask you if you'd join me in thanking all those people up there that have worked to set this up, staff, technology people, please. It hit me on the drive here that I wanted to clarify, so this graduates, most of them were born in 2004, correct? Mr. Heinke joined me in 2004 as assistant principal. So that ages him and ages you. Well, I want to congratulate Mr. Heinke, and I hope you join me. Mr. Heinke is going to stand right now. He's the assistant principal that's retiring at the end of the year. So I think it's only fitting that you step up here Emily and Zach, he's going to walk out with you as you take the class out because you all are going to retire.
Thank you. Thank you.